pretty close now.
Let's stop and go on foot from here. Just up the hill this way. Follow me. There's a spot up ahead where we should be able to get a good look at the place. I want to make sure we don't run into any surprises.
Sure.
Apparently, this family's been isolated for so long, they started talking in their own weird dialect. They really don't like outsiders, especially on their turf.
Well, you just keep selling me on this job, don't you?
Oh, big place, right?
Well, there's a pretty big barn in the back. It's not a bad place to start looking. There must be a lot of people living here. A large house.
This could be in any one of them buildings, and who knows how many people are in there.
I ain't sure about this.
I think we need to draw them out somehow. I got an idea. Follow me.
All these trees, I can't get a proper look at the place.
Well, hopefully it'll make it harder for them to spot us, too.
The coast seems clear so far.
Yeah, so far.
Hey, keep it down. I hear voices. Hide behind this shed. See if we can hear what they're saying.
Shut your gopher, you gopher. Passing yourself a bunch of duel from the horse. Maybe use hunted pig this time with mouth. Creepers, bitch. Don't score noses in the gypsy climbing.
Stay low.
Just stay quiet.
Where you been now, dude? Don't be boiling now, Pappy. I's gone but 10 minutes I was.
You can lollygag all the now day long, because Edie takes patrol now, don't you?
What? No, Edie, get all the jam!
You shut your gumper, or I'll flagger your felt, I will. You need to pull it up, boy. Up. Go guard the shed.
Go!
You understand what they're saying?
Not much of it. What are we doing, Javier?
Okay, you take cover by the rock over there. I'll create a little distraction, and then you jump them, okay?
What kind of distraction?
You'll see.
Stay quiet!
Thank you.
you heard me, Outlander?
Look what we have here.
I told you it was worth the trouble, didn't I?
Here, you take this. Let's split up. I'll meet you back at camp.
Sounds good.
Nazis, dog!
Don't tempt me, you repulsive little maggot.
I love you too.
We're gonna run out of meat here soon if we're not careful.
I know supplies are low.
Good job, Mr. Morgan. I've come up with some ideas for ways we could improve things around here if you want to take a look. That'll make everyone happy, I'm sure of it.
Well, a few changes never hurt.
Ah, what a delightful surprise.
Hello, Karen.
Hello, Miss Grimshaw. How is your mood?
Fine. I'm so glad.
You know, while we were stuck up that mountain, I thought long and hard about if we had to eat you. Very amusing. I suggested we roast you alive.
Good work, Arthur.
Mr. Pearson was keener on chopping you up and turning you into stew. Said he couldn't bear to see your face for even one moment longer than he had to. Well, you're quite the amusing companion, aren't you? I like to think so. Thank you.
Hey, Arthur!